Okay, I'm going to take a first shot at trying to record my morning yoga session. Okay, so many of you have been asking me to show some of my workout routine, some of my yoga that I do. And that's not what my channel is going to be about, but I do a lot of things that my channel isn't about, because ultimately my channel is about me, and I'm not all about a lot of things that I dive into my channel. Three deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth. Then, alternate nostril breathing. I usually like to start with the left nostril inhaling. So you want to do that three times, because this all involves total mobility. This is what this is a total mobility training. We're going to separate the right shoulder from the right side of the neck. This is designed as a morning activator. So, it's a little bit of yin, and it's a little bit of yang. You're not spending too much time on any particular stretch, but you're not rushing through it or trying to get a calorie burn out of it either. Center at the end, interlace behind the head, and twist. Now interlock your hands on your shoulders, and we're going to twist at the hips, inhale on the left, exhale on the right, and then reverse it after your back feels sufficiently unwound. now we're going to move over to the voiceovered part of the practice.
So we're going to start with these fist pumps. We're going to be raising our arms to our sides as we reach up to the sky and then continue on the way back down and then swoop forward doing the same thing, coming back down. Now make T-Rex arms to rotate at the wrists clockwise and anti-clockwise 3 times. Then repeat this process at the elbows, and the shoulders, and then as arm rotation. Do one arm at a time for the extreme rotation forwards and backwards. It can't be done to this level with both arms at the same time. The shoulder blades get in the way. Then after this, we're hooking the arm across the chest and making counter resistance with our other arm. We rotate and do this again. Then after this one, I'm going to turn around so you can see this on my back also. Many people are not flexible enough to do this, so, you know, you get where you can with it, but you want to interlock your hands as such, and this has a better stretch on the arm that is up than it does on the arm that is down. But it does stretch both. I like to do these little small contortions as well, because the idea is that we're opening everything up. After the arms have been done, we move on to the legs. Now, me personally, I'm still working on one leg stability, so you're going to see me hop around a little bit. And I'm constantly striving to find that center balance. And of course, I'm working on getting my gut down, which will also improve my balance. But I hook it behind me at the glutes, and then I tuck it in ahead of me. And just like with the arms, we do ankle, knee, and hip rotations. Same thing. Clockwise and anti-clockwise 3 times each leg. Sometimes, if you have the time, you might want to do some calf raises before you do this to work on your standing stability. Now for this one, I use the assistance of my couch. And I am not good with the names of various different stretches. And as a yoga practice, I'm going to be coming up with my own names instead of using all of the awesome terms in Sanskrit. But I'm going to be more interested in the future in Norsing it up. But as you can see, I both go for a forward bend as well as these side bends, which this just gives extra hip opening. Then from this point, we're getting on the floor of the mat. You can see my gut in progress. And I go from plank. And as a morning thing, I'll do like 5 push-ups. Come down to belly. And then baby cobras. And you want to do this for a little bit. You're opening up the chest. You're working on your spinal flexibility some more. You also get a lot out of stretching the optic nerve, too. Whenever you're stretching, be mindful of where you're looking and even have your eyes look as far in the direction that you are stretching that you can. And all of those nerve endings are connected inside the body in very interesting ways. After that session of the baby cobra, you just want to lay prone with your arms down to the side and take some breaths and let yourself relax a little bit in this position. You can take as long as you like with any of these more held and yin-oriented poses. This is being done in a more comprehensive, timely fashion to get you started on your day if you're going to work in the morning or something like that. So I stiffen the body up here and I push myself up into plank. Then I hit tabletop. Get the cat-cow action, as well as the various torso rolls and movements. A little bit of a chaturanga push-up will be done as well. But if I've learned anything, it's about your spinal flexibility has everything to do with your ability to be young. Like I said, the chaturanga. Then I pull it back. Sometimes I do a narrow child's pose. I'm doing a wide child's pose here. Do your best to fall back onto the heels of your foot, stretching all the way back, and then stretching your body all the way in the other direction at the same time. Takes me a hot minute to remember to go that far also. And then these little jerking motions are just getting all the little kinks out of the neck, all the little cricks out of the lower back and the hips. So, yep. Pop up into downward facing dog. I try to get myself in a proper position where my feet are capable of holding flat to the mat. And you might want to try and pump your legs back and forth a little bit like I'm doing here. Usually you do that at the start. I didn't do it at the start for this one. My yoga is more flow state than regimented because I just do it every day and I just feel it out. So as you can see, I hop back into plank. Now this is where we do some of the heavy leg work. I tuck the knee in to the chest. I bring it out in the air. Sometimes you can do a three-legged dog. I usually do a three-legged dog. And then I'm going into a split. Then I repeat the process, obviously. Once you've come back to center at your plank position, we're hopping up into the forward fold. I like to sit here for a minute, and like with all of my deeper, more yin-oriented stretches, I try to get in there deep. Try to get my forehead to my knees. And I have my position where my hands are on the ground. And then paint with your fingers, they call it. And then you do those little twists. You grab your alternate elbows. And then from here, you do your slow rise. Vertebrae to vertebrae. You get to the top, bring yourself up, and reach for the sky. Bring your hands together down to heart center. Then take the big super squat, and then hook your arms inside your knees. And then rock back and forth, trying to widen your legs by pushing back with your arms. Under usual circumstances, you are taking this pose at the head. You're going to reach behind you as I do here and prop yourself up on your legs and one arm, and then reach back, and then you're stretching your entire side. You prop yourself forward and rotate over and reach on the other side. I do this usually twice. If I'm trying to get an ab workout, I'll do it 10 times. Bringing the session to a close now, you lay down flat on your back, legs spread and arms spread the width of the mat, palms facing up, close your eyes, and check in with your body. Feel your stomach, your heart, and your head. Tune into all of your joints, all your vertebrae, everything that you just activated this morning. Take it in for a minute, then pop up to a seated position, bring your hands to heart center. And I like to do affirmations, mantras, if you will, at this particular point before I stand up to go conquer my day. Catch you guys later. Hope you conquer yours.